In 5 months' time, the state of Punjab has seen 2 major terror attacks, a point which has been raised by Congress expressing serious concerns of threat to the state. The Pathankot attack, interestingly, comes a week after PM Modi did a surprise visit to Lahore. While questions are being raised on whether the Indo-Pak dialogue will be derailed, even Pakistan on its part is condemning the act and has said that both India and Pakistan will fight the scourge of terror in a united fashion. Just a week after Prime Minister Narendra Modi's dramatic touchdown in Lahore, Pakistani terrorists attacked the strategically vital Pathankot Air Force Base on Saturday morning, highlighting the challenge involved in the attempt to restore normalcy with Pakistan.
I had said myself on various televisions that though the Prime Ministers are meeting, the attack by Pakistan-sponsored attack is round the corner. It just happened. In fact, I said about 2-3 weeks, but it happened very fast. They've beaten me to it also. So this is going to happen because army of Pakistan does not want to lose control. And if Prime Minister gets into control, India-Pakistan come closer, the visas are waived off, the trade increases, then the army loses its total identity. 85% business of Pakistan is controlled by army. Army does not want to do this. There's a money behind everything. Is the economic gain behind it. It is not so simple as that, bad and good and evil and devil, nothing of that sort. It is pure economic gain, which army does not want to do.
The pre-dawn Fidayeen raid by terrorists belonging to the Jaish-e-Mohammed led by Maulana Masood Azhar, seeking to enter the strategically crucial forward operating base located barely 40 km from the Indo-Pak border and at the strategic tri-junction of Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab and Himachal Pradesh, is home to a squadron of MiG-21 fighters and Mi-25 and Mi-35 attack helicopters. The jihadis were reportedly asked by their handlers to specially destroy the aircraft and choppers.
Attack on the Pathankot Air Base has been a very, very bold attack. There is no doubt about it. But it has been a complete intelligence failure and complete failure of coordination between the security agencies, which involves the defense agencies as well as the local civil agencies.
At least 5 terrorists, one of them identified as Nasir Khan, were killed in an exchange of fire with commandos of the National Security Guards and Indian Air Force. 3 security personnel, including 1 Air Force commando, were also killed in the operation. The slain Punjabi-speaking terrorists, part of a Jaish-e group based in Pakistan's Bhawalpur, were taking instructions from their handlers, Maulana Ashfaq and Haji Abdul Shakur.
आज मानवता के दुश्मनों ने जो भारत की प्रगति को देख रहे थे उनको परेशानी हो रही है, ऐसे तत्वों ने, ऐसी ताकतों ने पठानकोट में हिंदुस्तान की सैन्य शक्ति का एक महत्वपूर्ण अंग एयरबेस को उड़ा देने का प्रयास किया। देश के सुरक्षा बलों को बधाई देता हूं कि दुश्मनों के उन इलाकों को उन्होंने हाथ में चला है, उनको सफल नहीं होने दिया। और जिन जवानों ने शहादत की है उनकी शहादत को मैं नमन करता हूं।
पावर्ड बाय NNIS।